Elika Frederick. Bienvenue à dans l'autre segment Belte Saint Lucia. Jodi a, nou ka hen epi bon box. Yo ka fè dezen pou had et bijou spécial. An wè sa yo ni. Hi Kim.
Hey.
What's up?
I'm good.
All right, nice. What's on display here? I like
we
this
have,
color.
Oh, yes. This is a beautiful pink to match your outfit. We have our Me Time Mood Pause, a perfect pop of color to add to any outfit.
Nice.
It's not too bad with yours today, right?
Mm-hmm. Nice. What's this little book?
Oh, we have our Dapper Notes notebooks that we collaborated with an artist on to handmade these that we designed the cover for.
Okay, nice. Can we chat some more on this?
Sure, let's do that.
Awesome. Thanks again, Kim, so much for agreeing to have this conversation.
My pleasure.
Où ça parle quoi, y'all?
A little bit. Tisak, tisak.
Until yet? Okay, we'll see about that. We'll see how it goes. But, I had, a little pre-conversation with you and you expressed, how passionate you are about, expressing yourself, finding, discovering yourself,
yes.
I should say, through creativity and art. Tell us, how do you do that?
There are different ways, but for me specifically, I like to make things. So whatever it is, I love to paint, I love to do crafts, I love to sew. I mean, as you could tell, I find it so calming to just find my zone and just do whatever I feel like doing. I literally will find something on the floor and find several different things to do with it. And I feel like that process of creativity is just something that everybody needs to have a little bit of in their lives,
mm-hmm.
because it creates a level of balance that we don't have every day. So for me, I absolutely love making things.
Okay. So when did you start discovering yourself? When? How long ago did that start?
It's been a while. It's been a continuous effort for me, but I could say over the last couple of years, I've really honed in on discovering myself. Because as an entrepreneur, I find that a lot of us tend to lose ourselves in our professionalism and our personal lives take a back burner. So somebody asks you, what do you do for your job? And it's like, I'm this, I'm that person, I could do this, and you call all of your accolades. But then when it's time to ask, what do you like? Who are you as a person? How is Mia?
Mm-hmm.
you really lose touch of who you are. So it's, I feel like for me, I had to take a step back and really think about who is this person? What am I trying to do? What is this all about? Because in trying to accomplish everything else around Bandbox and everything that we were trying to do with the business and the brand to grow it, we sort of lost touch of why we were doing it and the messaging behind the business and the brand.
So yes, Kim, how did your name for your brand, Bandbox, what does that stand for?
Bandbox means the equivalent of well-groomed and sophisticated. When I started 10 years ago, I came up with everything around the same iteration. But for me, Bandbox, I wanted it to have a unisex feel. So I couldn't go with dapper because that's too masculine. And I couldn't go with chic because that's too feminine. I wanted something really in the middle, but that didn't feel like clothing or dressing because I knew it was always about expression and creativity and really just loving whatever you're doing. So I found the meaning of Bandbox as a hat box, which is actually round. And it was used back in the 1920s when rich people would dress up. Everybody would get a hat made for them to look really good. So there was an old saying, you look like you step out of a bandbox, which means that you look dressed to the nine, you look fantastic. So I was like, that's it, bandbox. And I love the ring of it. I love the oxymoron of the fact that it says box, but it's actually round. So it felt like the perfect fit for me.
Very nice. I'm impressed. So Kim, tell us more about your line. What do you specialize in?
We have our signature mood cords. A mood cord, just like what I'm wearing, is essentially our statement piece. It's our signature product that's supposed to symbolize your freedom of expression and you just doing something really different. We started making them really big, actually bigger than this. When we designed it, it was supposed to be a really grand piece to stand out by itself and to really make a statement that, hey, I'm not here to fit in, I'm here to stand out. So that's where the mood cord came from. And we started making the iterations. We have the long weekend mood court, which is a style like what I'm wearing, and the me time mood court, which is a little different. As you can tell, the names are around like feelings of really taking time for yourself and your own expression, your own time. So that's how we like to make sure that people feel around our products. But we're excited to bring out some really new designs and really unique one-of-a-kind pieces that would really take in and hone in on the name mood court and the concept that we really want people to feel.
Nice. And you have your mood cords going on, but I see you have books as well,
some
mood pads. So tell us what do you have in store?
I'm a designer at heart. I just love making things. When the notebook thing happened, it literally was serendipitous. I saw this designer, Dapper Notes, and he's from New Jersey. I saw him on Instagram and I was like, oh my gosh, I have to collaborate with this artist. What he does is he makes handmade pocket notebooks, but every cover is designed by an artist. So literally, you just send in your design, you collaborate, and we got to decide what the fabric was and what the inside was. And because I'm horrible at making those types of decisions, I came up with 6 designs, and I just made all 6 designs the design. So it looks like a bit of an heirloom quilt type look, and the fabric is actually a crushed velvet, so it's really soft to the touch, it's iridescent. So depending on how you look at it in the light, it looks a little different. And every notebook looks different because once it's cut down, there's literally no way to replicate it. And that's one of the things I love about what I do. And that's one of the things I love about how we design. It's just about taking things that you wouldn't expect and just going with the flow, going with how you feel and just expressing yourself, because it's okay. In art, there's really no wrong answer. It's how you feel, what you do, and who doesn't like it. That's them and them again. We're poor.
I like that. So you use African print, you use the madras,
yes.
What else is it? What inspires you? Do you have any particular, patterns,
honestly,
that you're into, or into any and everything?
It's not any and everything. I feel like I'm really drawn to unique and geometric style patterns. I'm not necessarily drawn to African fabric either. I just really love cotton because for the mood cords, it's important to me that the fabric is breathable so that it doesn't hold in heat and start irritating around your neck. Every woman knows the struggle of just having that heat sitting there, especially when you live in the Caribbean. Like, that's not a struggle I want for anybody. So that's why we don't put any metals in it or anything. And as you can tell, it's really lightweight.
Right.
So for me, I wanted to make sure that it's something comfortable to wear. So that's why we gravitated towards the African fabric, because it's a lot of just black type colors. You know, it's very loud, it's very Caribbean, it's very a bunch of colors nobody should put together that's just together. So it just felt very good to me. I had no idea that African fabric was a thing. I gravitated towards the fabric and then I started using it. So for me, it's just about print and making sure that it fits whatever we're going to do with it, because I won't necessarily use the crushed velvet for a stock item like a mood cord, because for me, if I make that now, it's just going to keep you hot. So unless it's a special type of order where somebody says, okay, I'm comfortable with this, this is what I prefer, this is what I like, then I'll do that. But for me, it's about just coloring people. It's very selfish. But for me, I love taking my world of color and how I surround myself with a lot of colors, and I understand how it impacts your emotions and your everyday life. So I want to bring that to people so they could feel the beautiful world of color and how the expressiveness of that helps with your everyday life.
Awesome. Sabon. Bobagai. Where can we find you if we're interested in buying any of your pieces, your beautiful pieces at that?
We have a Facebook store, an online store, and an Instagram store. Our handles are all at The Bandbox Official and TheBandboxOfficial.com. We also started a new YouTube channel that I'm very excited about, where we share our story and we share different techniques and avenues with people to help them express themselves in their own way. Because expressing yourself doesn't necessarily mean to wear a mood cord, as much as I would love you to. You could color. We teach you how to do art techniques. We teach you how to just channel your creativity in your own, whether you like to cook, whether you like to plant in your garden, whether you like to go for walks or just chill on the beach. I really love just helping people embrace their creativity and embrace their self-expression. So you can find us over there as well at Bandbox.
Thank you so much, Kim.
You're
messy
welcome.
Appeal. It was certainly a pleasure chatting with you. Belte Cozy. Yes, Belte Cozy.
Merci,
Ashai. All right, sir?
Oui. Jounen kouyol mama,
jounen kouyol mama,
jounen kouyol papa,
jounen kouyol papa,
jounen kouyol mamay,
jounen kouyol mamay,
jounen kouyol tout moun,
jounen kouyol tout moun.
Miseri Pregno, Vini Amis Tegno, Vini Lesche Tuerno.